Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. So far on our journey using the Alpha channel, we've traveled through importing files with Alpha, compositing with map containers in the sequence, and dealing with internally generated Alpha using 2D text. For generic layer compositing, the video tracks in the sequence are more than enough to get the job done. But once you start pushing the boundaries beyond simple layer compositing, you need to approach compositing in a different way. For example, if you're given CGI renders for photorealistic compositing, or perhaps your client wants you to give them more than just a flat title, you need to use the ConnectFX node-based compositor. You use this tool to solve some of the more complex compositing tasks, and the Alpha channel is just as essential as ever. The workflow in Smoke is that you access ConnectFX through the sequence. This means you can bring Alpha channels into ConnectFX in two ways. Using the matte container that combines the fill and Alpha in one segment, like an embedded file, or a single pass per clip, meaning you have one clip for your RGB color channels and one clip for the black and white Alpha channel. We'll go through an example of each one. So here we have a sequence with a matte container on the second layer. To take this into ConnectFX with its background, hold Command and multi-select both segments. Click the Effects button to bring up the Effects ribbon. Just before we enter into ConnectFX, I just want to bring something to your attention. You will note that Generate Composite is ticked. Smoke is assuming that you are going to composite the two segments together, so it will create the right settings to blend the sources in ConnectFX. So when you click Create ConnectFX, you enter into the node-based compositing world, and Smoke has created an action composite for you, and your sources are now blended together. Just for show, if I select the action node, the result in the viewer is the combined composite of the background and the matte container. More interestingly for this video series, is what Smoke has done to the matte container in ConnectFX. Comparatively, you have a single node, much like the original file with an embedded Alpha. There are two outputs coming out of this node. The first output is the RGB color channel, and the second output is the Alpha or matte channel. It is worth pointing out that the blue color always symbolizes the matte or Alpha channel in ConnectFX. This is represented in the colors going in and out of the nodes, as well as the connection between the nodes. When a node is connected like you see here, the top half of the thumbnail shows the color channels, and the bottom half of the thumbnail shows the Alpha channel. Please take note that this is not a bug or corruption. Now with the source node selected, the first thing you will see in the result viewer is the RGB color channel. Press F4 to allow the viewer to cycle between the color channel and the Alpha channel of the selected node. For terminology's sake, the result view is the color channels, and the out matte view is your Alpha channel. Now let's move on and look at a scenario where I have separate clips for the color channel and the Alpha channel. This is without the use of the matte container. So in this sequence, I just have the RGB channel clip on the second layer. Select the graphic and the background using Command and multi-selection. I will now click the Effects button and choose to create ConnectFX. This time in the ConnectFX schematic, the source clip only has one output for the RGB color channel. By design, Smoke also feeds the same RGB color channel into the matte input of action. This is something we will need to rectify in a moment. To bring the Alpha channel source clip into ConnectFX, just locate it in the media library. You can drag it directly out of the media panel and drop it into the ConnectFX schematic. So here you have the RGB channel source clip and the Alpha channel source clip. Both of them only have one output. Remember what I said earlier, anything to do with Alpha is always blue in ConnectFX. But looking at the Alpha clip, the output is not blue. Currently, Smoke just sees the source clip as a regular RGB clip. If you were to drag a connection from the alpha clip into any blue matte input, then the connection will turn blue. This means the source is now being used as the alpha. Finally, let's look into the action node and see how the composite looks. Double-clicking the action node will bring up the result in the viewer as well as the action controls. Straight away, you will see a problem. The graphic is not keying through to show the background. The issue we have is that we have to tell Action how to use the alpha correctly on this specific graphic. Switch to the Media menu and select the first media input. The thumbnail on the left shows us that the RGB channel is seen, but the alpha or matte channel is off. This is because originally there was no alpha channel with the source. To enable the connected alpha channel clip, switch the matte on. So this particular media input 1 now knows it is receiving the correct RGB channel and its corresponding alpha or matte channel. So those are two ways of getting your alphas into ConnectFX, but ultimately the compositing result will be the same. Please note that there is no way in ConnectFX to create a matte container. If you wish to do so, exit ConnectFX and create it using the Create Matte Container option via the Tools menu. In the next video, we look at the alpha inputs and outputs of ConnectFX nodes, as well as getting your alphas out of the Action Compositor. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.